Colorado Avalanche Hockey on Altitude is brought to you by Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum taste. Groove Subaru on Broadway or online at grooveauto.com. Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online only at southwest.com. CenturyLink. CenturyLink has it all. Broadband, entertainment, and voice. Visit CenturyLink.com. And by Sonic. For the perfect snack or meal, pop in anytime for Sonic's Jumbo Popcorn Chicken. We're expecting another sellout here in Nashville for this game between the Avalanche and the Predators, with the Avalanche sitting at 74 points, second in the division, 10th in the conference. The Nashville Predators, what a season they're having, 83 points, but they are coming off a loss here at home, and that hasn't happened very often in this building this season. The puck is dropped, and here we go. Avalanche and Nashville playing for the third time this season. Nashville has taken the first two contests this year. Nashville ices the puck. We got our first whistle just 12 seconds in. Let's take a look at tonight's starting goaltender, brought to you by Southwest Airlines.
Well, when they give out the Vezina Trophy this year to the best goaltender, Pekka Rinne may be amongst the finalists. But right now, the best goaltender in hockey is Semyon Varlamov. He has allowed 5 goals in his last 6 games. One of them was a penalty shot, only 2 even strength goals.
A shot tipped in front after the Avs won the draw. It comes back up the boards, and Martin Erat, number 10 for the Nashville Predators. He's been good against the Avs, 10 points in the last 6 games against Colorado. So a guy to certainly keep your eye on if you're the Avs. Downey chasing the puck along with Landeskog, but it comes back into the Nashville zone. Shot ahead through the neutral zone. Avs get it back. Pass up for O'Reilly. And he'll send one in over the head of Rene. Snap that puck down. He's a big guy. He's one of the tallest guys, yet his backup is even bigger than he is. Anders Lindbäck.
Yeah, he's a shrimp compared to his backup. And I just went in their locker room today before the after practice just to see how big on skates he is. Like, he's so imposing. He is just huge with his pads on.
Avalanche trying to push the puck out of the zone, and finally squirts to center, taken there by David Jones. Nice move! Oh, and just a little poke check. Shot, score! Jamie McGinn, he is on fire! There's a guy who is just finding a way to score goals for the Avs of late. That is 4 in 3 games now for Jamie McGinn. What a deal to get him from San Jose. He gets the early goal, but really, Peter, give a lot of credit on this to David Jones.
This was a one-on-one where Jones just created the mismatch with speed. He beat the defenseman wide, and then all of a sudden Nashville, they seem to have numbers coming back, but all of a sudden McGinn, you see what he did, Mike, right there? He went to the inside post hard. He didn't sort of fade to the outside. He went hard to the front of the net and pokes it home. And the Avalanche now with Jamie McGinn. Like, he's had the game-winning goal in the last 2 games. He's had, as you mentioned, 4 goals his last 3 games for the Avalanche, and he has just been great.
There to center ice by Milan Hajduk as we look at the old Chicago scoring summary. Jamie McGinn now 16 goals this season, 4 of them for the Avs, and David Jones gets the assist. And for Jones, that is his 15th assist of the season. But Jamie McGinn, when you saw that the trade involving Jamie McGinn, you didn't necessarily think, here's a guy who's just going to come in and solve a lot of your scoring problems. But, man, has he just found a way to score while with the Avalanche?
Yeah, you got to have that Gordie Howe hat trick last game, a fight, a goal, an assist. But, Mike, I think one of the things he's really done is he's found, not just playing well, he's found a home on that line with Stastny and Jones. Each of them right now playing really good hockey. So that gives the Avalanche not just O'Reilly's line that's been good all season, but now a second line that they can count on.
Now we see a line of Mike Connolly along with Jay McClement and Cody McLeod out on the ice. Connolly was a healthy scratch last game, but the injury to Matt Duchene has allowed Connolly to get back into the lineup for the Avalanche. Hunwick dashing back behind the net. Going to move the puck, smashed out to center. That's the only change in the lineup from the last game. With Matt Duchene's injury, Ryan O'Byrne off the injured list. He is available to play now, but he is a healthy scratch. He's Coach Joe Sakic staying with the same six defensemen he had in the last two wins against Minnesota.
And we've seen Joe Sakic do that a lot this year.
Steal, and the shot blocked and tipped away, and the Avalanche move out towards center, but then stolen back. The cross-ice pass to Tutu, and it's chipped out to center.
And when Joe Sakic gets comfortable with the lineup and they win, he very seldom makes changes.
Score! Shot from the top of the circle by Mike Fisher. And the Nashville Predators have tied the game at one.
Well, this is absolutely not the kind of game we thought we'd see. We talked about the goaltenders, how well they play. The Vezina Trophy will certainly be one of the trophies that Pekka Rinne might be, you know, involved in at the end of the year. Varlamov playing brilliant hockey for the Avalanche. And we're 1-1, and we haven't even played 3 minutes in this hockey game. But Mike, it is interesting to watch. Both of these teams are coming off a game with a lot of goals. The Avalanche won 7-1, and they had seven different guys score in that game. And Nashville lost to the LA Kings 5-4. So it's been carrying over into tonight's game.
Fine with us, right?
Oh, we're very happy.
With the puck along the near side, Landeskog, he'll move out to center ice. 16 minutes, 45 seconds still to go in the first period already. A goal for each team. Big hit behind the Nashville net. And the puck caroms out towards center ice. Brought in by the defenseman Suter. He gets slowed up by Hayden. The puck is bumped out to center ice. Downey chased down. Suter back to get to the puck. O'Reilly took it from him, poked it ahead, and Legwon. Last time these two teams played, David Legwon won the game for Nashville in overtime. Pass to center ice, off of Erat's skate to the near corner. Tap back up the boards. Avalanche get it back, near side wing, McGinn out to center. So, what have we had so far? At 1:14, a goal from Jamie McGinn, assisted by David Jones. And then at 2:54, Mike Fisher scoring his 20th goal of the season. Pass comes across, angled out towards center ice by McGinn. Pushed off the boards, and then the glass bounced back into the Nashville zone. Taken by Roman Josi. Cross ice pass for Ira. His pass slowed up by Jan Hayda of the Avalanche, but then knocked ahead by Nashville into the Colorado zone. Back in and around the boards. Hayden makes the pass for Hayden. Skate out towards center to the red line. Shot in from center ice. He's behind the net. Rene sent it across up the middle. Tipped out towards center. Pushed away off the boards. Knocked back in. Looking behind him. Pushed away by Ryan Ellis of Nashville. Bounce back for the Avalanche. They give to Mueller. Nice move. He cuts in. His shot was deflected. Back up the boards. Ryan Wilson has it for the Avs, makes the pass for Mueller. His pass tipped out to center ice.
This is a Nashville club that doesn't have that great big star up front that's going to overwhelm you with, you know, the big numbers at this time of the year. But they like to throw four lines. They believe can all score. Great balance, and like to spend a lot of time in the opposing's offensive zone. Like to get in there and really attack.
Well, that goal by Mike Fisher's 20th of the season ties him with the team leader Patrick Hornqvist with 20 goals, and that's the top for the Nashville Predators. Out at center ice, Preds with the puck, flipped off the boards into the Colorado zone, pushed back the other way. Crowd getting into it. They just saw Jordan Tutu with a hit. They love him here in Nashville. Shot around the boards by McClement in the Predators zone. Preds had the puck, outlet pass towards center ice, and tipped back by the Avalanche into their own zone. Defenseman Shane O'Brien spent last year as a member of the Nashville Predators, skating the puck to center ice. To the red line, into the Nashville zone, is across the blue line with the puck, but it is an offside play. We'll be back shortly. It is a 1-1 hockey game in Nashville in the first period.
Early in the first period, we've already had a goal by Fisher on the left and Jamie McGinn on the right. And let's look at the Avalanche goal. This is a great effort by David Jones, but also a real strong move by McGinn. The people were on him. He drives in that stick on the ice and pokes it home. And the Avalanche get unlucky, bounced in off the defenseman's knee in behind Semyon Varlamov, and we've got off to, Mike, a real interesting start here. I've been impressed with the Avalanche. I haven't seen intimidated by a Nashville club that can really come at you hard. The Avalanche have controlled the puck and gotten it in deep.
Rene will handle the puck, sends it off the glass, and then carried out towards center ice. Pushed over the line to the near side. Erat with a chance, but off the heel of the stick and easily gathered in by Varlamov.
And what has just been a tough year has gotten even tougher for Matt Duchene. Matt Duchene missed 20 games. This was his ninth game back, last game against Minnesota, and he tears up. He first hurt that left knee. Now he's hurt his right ankle. And Mike, we were talking to the coaching staff this morning, 3 to 4 weeks, which basically says maybe the game's on April 5th and 7th if everything goes well.
After the draw, the puck comes up the ice. End up being an icing call. There's the whistle as Ryan Suter touches the puck for Nashville.
And you have to give the Avalanche credit for staying in it. Joe Sakko's club has found ways to win. Because you look at Matt Duchene, he missed 20 games. The games that he was in, he was just starting to find himself, but he only had a goal and assist. And then he's going to be out pretty much the remainder of the schedule. So last year's leading scorer basically not playing over the course of the last half of the season.
Matt Duchene, and this is game number 69 of the season for the Avs. Matt Duchene has played in 48. Shot and a save made by Varlamov. Well, Nashville, they can really come at you with some power to the front of the net.
And what they do well is you watch them drive to the net. You see the Avalanche players collapsing, which most clubs do defensively. Mike, what happens then? That's where the defensemen like Suter and Weber jump up into the play, and that's what makes them so dangerous. Semyon Varlamov, I mean, coming into tonight's game, some of the numbers were unbelievable. One goal by a forward in six games. I mean, it's just phenomenal.
5-1 in his last six starts, and the last two starts he's had on the road, Peter, both been shut out. Shot with a point, and it's a 2-1 lead for the Nashville Predators. If it wasn't tipped, Roman Josi will get credit for his fifth of the season, and Nashville leads 2-1.
And again, that just the quick play off the faceoff, and Josi, who, like, we hadn't seen him. This is rookie season. Playing, I believe, his 46th game. We saw him last time. He has got a bomb. But so many bodies in front of Varlamov right here. Did it hit? No, it may have gone right through, but he was screened.
Well, the Avs scored early at 1:14. Jamie McGinn got the Avs off to a great start, but now two long shots by the Nashville Predators have gone into the back of the net, and it's a 2-1 advantage for the Preds. Air to center ice by Josi, ahead for Erat. Shot into the Colorado zone, tip to the corner. Hunwick gets it up ice, pass intercepted. Fisher takes it for Nashville. Sent around back behind the net by Sergei Kostitsyn. And Erat working his way up towards the blue line. Poke check by Elliott. And Elliott chased it all the way to the Nashville blue line. Nashville still with possession. Shot into the Colorado zone. Hunwick backhands it around for Elliott. Just looked to check. Makes the pass off the boards from McLeod. Sends it across. McClement with a chance. And that one is tipped around the glass. Chased down by Mike Connolly. Made his debut a couple of games ago in the game against the Minnesota Wild in Minnesota. Well, they're giving credit to former Avalanche Brandon Yip. So apparently he tipped that as he was setting the screen. Josi took the shot, and Bork. That's Gabriel Bork with the assist, and it's a 2-1 lead for the Nashville Predators.
Well, let's have another look at the goal. I had a real nice talk with Brandon Yip this morning, Mike, and he was saying that this is a tough team. It just bounces off his shin pad right in front. But this is what Nashville does, and this is why they've liked Brandon Yip with this club. Another guy that goes to the front of that, just jumps in front, goes to the front, and allows those big shots in the point, as we were talking about, to become part of the offense for Nashville.
Scooped down the boards by O'Brien, then sent across Landeskog into the Nashville zone. His shot goes wide of the net. Up the wing to the corner. 11 minutes, 10 seconds still to play in the first period. Predators with two goals on four shots. Avs one goal, two shots offside Nashville. But I think there's also going to be a penalty. At least Rene was headed towards the box. Yes, here comes the referee to announce the penalty. Stephen Walkham making the announcement.
Number five, Colorado, minor penalty, interference.
The reason that was called, if O'Brien had waited that extra split second, right here takes the man down, and the puck wasn't close enough to allow him to get away with that one. So the Avalanche now, Mike, there are not many power plays, you know, in these games anymore. They've killed off nine in a row, but you got to watch Weber and his shot.
He's number six for Nashville. Makes the pass to Erat. Back high in the slot. Suter and Weber back on the points for Nashville. Cross ice pass. Erat. Shot save made by Varlamov. Back up the boards. Suter finds Erat. Immediately checked. Or Erat with the puck sent to the cross for Weber. Bounced away from him. And tipped out of play. Faceoff will be in the neutral zone.
And it's interesting being around both these clubs this morning. You know, for the Avalanche, you could feel that, okay, Mike, those two games against Minnesota, they won them. They did what they had to do, but it was time to move on. For Nashville, you could feel that they really felt they didn't play well against Los Angeles. 2 points they really wanted, and there was sort of that little bit of that anger going on in their locker room.
Nashville up 2-1 and on a power play. How is their power play? Oh boy, are they good. Second best in the league. Kostitsa dropped the puck in the corner from Legwand. Put it back behind the net. Sent back to the point, Weber. Slides it across. Back to Weber. Down the near side boards. Back high in the slot for Suter. Side of the net, Kostitsa fanned on a pass. Recovers, makes the pass back at the blue line for Suter. Kostitsa below the circle of the pass for David Legwand. Down low, sent across in the slot, bouncing puck up in the air is behind the net. And then cleared out by the Avs, Gabriel Landeskog.
Yeah, that puck was up. I'm not sure if a couple guys didn't actually hit that puck when it was in the air, but it was right there in front. And Mike, is that dangerous? Weber on that far side, just sort of going into that spot where no defenseman could go at him.
Fisher gets the puck in the corner of the Avalanche zone. The power play down the last dozen seconds, put out in front and covered in the crease by Varlamov. Let's take a look at the key to the game being delivered to you by Jimmy Johns.
Now handle this house. This place is, Mike, do you know that since 05-06, only Detroit has more home wins than Nashville. This is the second toughest building to come in and get a win in the entire National Hockey League.
And what's been nice for Nashville and for the league, Peter, they're selling out games. This has become a loud, fun place to watch a hockey game. And the team is winning. They are good at home, 21-8-5 this season. They didn't score on that power play chance. One shot during that power play opportunity. Remains a 2-1 lead for the Predators, though. In the corner, Fisher with the puck. He gets hit, but Erat will take it for the Preds. His pass slipped out to center. Josi waits. As soon as everybody's onside, delivers the puck back into the Colorado zone. Picked up behind the net, Hayter. Make the handoff for Eric Johnson. 8:25 to play in the period. 2-1 lead for Nashville. Fisher and Yip with the goals for Nashville. Jamie McGinn for the Avalanche. Got ahead by Hayden. Behind the net, Mueller. He gets checked. Passed the far side wing. Sent across, tipped out towards center ice. Brought down the near side wing by Bork. Put off the side of the net by Brandon Yip. Shoved away from the puck by Johnson. Outlet pass comes to center. Nashville got it back. Bouillon shoots it down the boards. Avalanche skate to center with possession. Over, poke check, but followed by Mueller in his shot. Goes up high. And around the glass, Shea Weber takes the puck to center ice for Nashville. His pass gets tipped. And sending deep into the near side corner of the Colorado zone. Back to get it. Elliott finds Hunwick. Back to Elliott. He's out in the fast. Scooped off the boards by Jones. Ahead for McGinn. That's stopped by Nashville, but Avs regain. Jones bumps. Just slipped the check. Jordan Tutu is going for the big hit. Avs have the puck in the Nashville zone. Throwing out of the corner. Jones sends a backhand pass in front. But it's Nashville. Tutu's pass hit escape. Weber being pushed. They got the pass. Up ice. And a tip at the Avalanche line, sent back the other way.
Mike, it's 2-1 score. You would think there'd be a wide-open hockey game. There's nowhere to move in that neutral zone. Both clubs playing well defensively.
Leguan's pass. Down the slot. Shot, save, rebound. Big save by Varlamov. Keeping the Avs within a goal. First, he had to stop Hornqvist coming down the slot. Then the rebound was there. Backhanded down the boards by Josi. Pass gets tipped. Josi waiting on the near side. Sends it down the boards. Kostitsyn back to the point. Shot. Knocked down. Hornqvist shot. Tipped in the air. And with the glove, Haida put it down to the ice. Backhanded back around by Josi. Centering pass by Hornqvist. The backhand try gets stopped. From the net, it was defenseman Ryan Wilson with the block. Steered away by Varlamov. A big Hal Gill, number 75 for Nashville. He made an already big team even bigger when he was acquired recently. Back to Gill at the point. Sent across for Josi. Down the boards and behind the net. Rounded out.
Good shift by Nashville right there. A lot of pressure, a lot of good hard work in that offensive zone. And the Avalanche, again, these are the ones you have to respond on. Like, you cannot allow this to become what's going to be played the rest of this period.
The Avs only have two shots, and one of them went in. And they're down just 2-1 in this game, but they've been outshot 7-2 so far in this first period. Rene will hold the puck for a faceoff. Jamie McGinn started off for the Avalanche, but then two goals for Nashville, Mike Fisher, and then Brandon Yip, and the Preds have the lead. Tonight's In the Groove, goaltender Semyon Varlamov.
And if you look at all of the numbers that he's been rolling up, you look at the goals that he's allowed. Doughty had a shot from the point that got by him. Bobby Ryan scored on a power play. Keaton scored on the power play. Tutin scored for Columbus, and last game, a penalty shot. That's it. Over the course of six games, five goals, a penalty shot, a couple of power play goals, and two at even strength.
Jones makes the pass to McGinn. Hand off to Johnson. His centering backhand pass picked off. Carried out towards center ice by Hal Gill. Scooped around behind the Avalanche net, centered off the skate. That was Brandon Yip in front of the net. Long pass ahead for Stastny. Down the slot for Jones. Backhand kick save made by Rene. Aired out towards center ice by Nashville. And that is Paul Gostad. We haven't talked that much about him. He's one of the players acquired in that trade deadline by Nashville. They wanted to get bigger down the middle.
They want to get bigger. They Gostad, who is a real good faceoff man. And he is a big, strong player. Mike, Nashville, you know, gave Buffalo a first-round pick to get him.
There's 4:10 remaining in the first period. And a 2-1 lead for Nashville. Mueller has the puck for Colorado up ice. Haydu able to backhand the puck into the Nashville zone behind the net. Rene, the shooter, up the boards. Martin Erat. Hounded by Mueller, but able to make the pass for Weber. And into the Colorado zone. Comes Kostitsyn, nice pass across. Fisher couldn't get around Elliott. Dropped it along the boards. Freerat back to Fisher. To the point. And Suter shot. And that one kicked away. In front. Over to the corner for Elliott. Nashville continues to put that pressure on.
And you can see how they score goals, Mike. They get the shot on it, and people are in front. Both goals scored on Varlamov in this period were deflections.
3:20 left in the first period. Predators leading the game 2-1. Weber back for the puck for Nashville. Landeskog steals. Wilson in the corner for O'Reilly. Downey, O'Reilly, and Landeskog. But look how deep in the zone Wilson is. Landeskog back at the point. There he is. They made a nice play to keep the puck in at the blue line. Leg one in front of the net. Bobbled the puck for a moment, but recovered. And is able to shoot it out to center ice. Tip back in. Weber slides it across for Suter. Well, they're going to be on the ice a lot, aren't they?
Well, they're going to be on the ice a lot, especially when O'Reilly's line has been on the ice. Every time O'Reilly, Landeskog, and Downey have been out there, Coach Trott throws out the big two.
Pass sent across for Ryan Ellis. Into the Colorado zone. 2-2 winds, but apparently it was an offside play. We'll be back with more. 2-1 Nashville.
You're all set.
2-1 Nashville in this first period here in Nashville. And Mike, wasn't a lot of big trades, but when you look at both of these clubs over the course of the last while before the trade deadline, Hal Gill a little bit before the trade deadline, but for the Colorado Avalanche, Downey McGinn and Connolly, who came over with McGinn, all of these players have really added to the fabric of their hockey clubs. For Nashville, you could clearly see they made a commitment to this being a big year. They were going to get as deep as they could in all positions for the Avalanche. They wanted toughness, and they got it.
Pass to center. Sergei Kostitsyn coming after the puck, but Johnson got in his way and took it away, skating up the wing. Kept in play. The Av zone. Kostitsyn's pass across. Back towards the point, Gill waves it around behind the net. Taken up ice by Shane O'Brien. Off the boards. And sent into the Nashville zone. Stasty. By the way, they've given an extra assist on that first goal. Jamie McGinn from David Jones and add Paul Stasty. On the scoring sheet, Stasny now with 27 assists.
And I think, again, we talk about that line for the Avalanche. Again, here tonight, they've had the most consistent, not much pressure for the Avalanche, but it's been that line.
Currently out over with Mueller and Hayden. Leg one for Nashville, 1:10 left in the period. Hayden. Scoops up the puck. Makes the pass across to the near point. Hayden shot. Skimmed wide. Suter. Able to tip the puck to center ice. Pass blocked at center by Hornqvist. Shot in wide. The Avalanche goaltender Weber with a chance right at the side of the net. Another shot by Hornqvist. And that's stopped by Varlamov. Hunwick picks up the puck. Skates out towards center. Yossi moves the puck to center ice. The Avs back get the win tomorrow. Take $2, go to a Denver area Subway restaurant, and choose between a cold cut combo or meatball marinara.
There's Paul Gostad right in the middle, Mike, and wondering how tough he is after the big hit Milan Lucic made on in Boston on Ryan Miller, the goaltender. And really, Buffalo at that time felt they didn't respond. The next time that Boston was in Buffalo, it was Gostad who went right up, first play, first whistle, and said, okay, let's get this straightened out. And you look down the middle of some of these clubs that they feel they're going to may play in the playoffs. They felt they needed that one great big guy.
After the draw, Suter shot towards Tutu. He's winding up for the big one-timer, but it went wide. Wrapper from behind the net, and again, Nashville, boy, they just drive to the front, Spalling to the 13. Was flying to the front of the net, trying to get to that loose puck. Spalling with the puck, lost it. Carried to center by the Avs at the line. Colorado is offside. 1:10. There's an injury. Yeah. That is Eric Johnson on the ice.
And he's been down for a while. I was watching Tutu behind the net. Well, he went to make the hit, Mike, and he just went up over. Watch him go up over the Nashville player. And seemed to hit.
He hit his head on the shelf there,
on Peter? On the yellow shelf that's atop the boards.
Well, they have just stopped the period now. There was a tenth of a second remaining, but with the injury to Eric Johnson, there's no sense in making everybody wait. So we have come to the end of the first period of play. You can see how the length that this is taking to help Eric Johnson. Matt Sokolowski, the head trainer for the Avalanche, is the one attending to the Avalanche defenseman.
Just have one more look at it. You're just going to watch Johnson. He goes to make your defensive play against the Nashville player who just, you know, sort of ducked. And you saw how his right side of his face appeared to be what hit the boards first. And he was in distress, Mike, instantly.
But he certainly is keeping that left leg up off the ice, though, too, Peter.
Yep.
Well, hopefully we can get an update for you to help Eric Johnson to the locker room. We have come to the end of the first period of play in Nashville. 2-1 for the Preds. Up next is the Toyota intermission report. Bill leads the game after one period in Nashville by a score of 2-1. And for the Avalanche, Peter, they start off really well with an early goal.
Lots to talk about in that first period as far as sort of setting up what happened. Here, Jones, just a terrific play right here. Cuts inside, big, strong power forward. But McGinn makes a great move to the front of the net, pounds it home 1-0. And then you would think, okay, the next couple of goals. Both of the goals against Semyon Varlamov here off the shin pads. One, Elliott right there, just dances in behind him off of Elliott's skate. And here, again, shot from the point, nice shot, but off of Brandon Yip's Mike Legg. So no one shot one past Barley yet, you know, and so I think for the Avalanche, that's what you build on. Yeah, there were a couple of goals, but guys, we did a good job defensively. The big question now, of course, Mike, is Eric Johnson. What happened to him? What is the situation? Jamie McGinn, now 4 goals in the last 3 games. The Avalanche forwards will have to wait and see what Johnson's situation is for Joe Sacco. You know, you're down to 5 defensemen inside a game where a club like Nashville loves to come at you. And those defensemen are really going to have to play well. And, Mike, your forwards owe it to the defensemen to make good plays.
It's Gabriel Landeskog. Stick handles way in, offside Avalanche.
We've had no word, and I'm always get so worried when a guy seems to hit his head, but he's, Mike, it also seemed to be when he was being carried off or carted off that he was having some problem with his left leg. And again, you never want to play doctor. It just looked like that was a tough hit that he when he went into those boards. And we will try to, as quickly as possible, find out what happened.
It's a 2-1 lead for Nashville. Peter, they have changed that second Nashville goal. No longer credit to Brandon Yip. Yossi does get credit for that goal for the Nashville Predators.
Yeah, we got the word from downstairs for the Avalanche. Eric Johnson's still being evaluated, and they have not given us the word of what's going on. So they're looking, obviously, to make sure and see what's going on with Eric Johnson. So Joe Sacco knows, like, this is a situation, 10 games in 17 days, and you lose one of your big horses on the back, on the blue line. He's eating up, Johnson's playing great. He's eating up 22 minutes a night, so somebody's going to play a lot of hockey here in this game.
After the face-off, Nashville with the puck. Slapped up the boards at the center. At the red line, O'Brien for Colorado had the puck tipped away. Jones, and the lead Stastny. Stastny does get to the puck, put off the boards for Jones. Pass back to the point, Hunwick. Hunwick and O'Brien. Wraparound try, there's a puck right in front, and slapped away from McGinn. And a race for the puck, and Legwan will get to it first. O'Brien right on him, pushed out in front. Slapped up off the boards, back to center ice. And again, racing after the puck. He starts the scoring in this game. 1:14, then Fisher, 2:54 for Nashville, tied it up. And now they're giving credit back to Yossi with the goal at 6:58. They made it 2-1 Nashville. Centering pass between the circles. Over. Sends it up the boards. Knocked back in. Offside Nashville.
I have a lot of hate, dude. Captain of this hockey club. And Mike, you could just, in talking to him this morning, there's nothing that he would like better than to get this club into the playoffs. They had a miserable year last year. And it's at that 30-game mark, which we've talked about a lot. This club was 3 games under .500, and it has worked itself back to be now 6 games over .500 and is playing its best hockey of the year right now.
Pass out to center for Elliott. Vice Hader scooped away from him, pushed to the middle circle. Over has the puck, pushed by Spaulding. Spaulding with it for Nashville. Back into the head, and then the puck drifts into the Nashville bench, out of play.
Let's look at the ice time leaders for the Colorado Avalanche, and you know, you see what's going to be happening. Eric Johnson, 21 minutes a game, and now, so that's over the course of the last two periods, Mike. That, of course, when you break it down, is 14 minutes. So the 14 minutes is going to have to be distributed amongst the other defensemen. You don't think that 3 minutes, maybe 4 minutes, is that big a deal? You bet it is. It tests you. So the Avalanche need good work by everybody, a good team effort defensively.
The other thing that changes, too, Peter, is that you stop having the pairing set during the game. Now, because of five and that odd number, you're going to be... You've got to adjust to playing with different partners.
And Johnson was doing it, was a big role in that first power play for the Avalanche.
Nashville centering pass between the circles, taken away by Colorado. Pushed up ice, Mike Connolly, number 18 for the Avalanche in the second game for Colorado.
Did you see who we ran into? Hal Gibson, who may be a foot taller.
Out of the corner, Paul Gostad. Moving the puck up the boards. Connolly got it for Colorado. Tosses the pass across. Hunwick shoots it in and off the stick of Pekka Rinne into the corner. Chance for Riley, and it's off a Nashville player and wide. Then bat it back behind the net. Around the glass it goes. Towards the point. Held in there by Downey. Down the slot. Shot by O'Reilly. Blocked. Bouncing puck between the circles and... hard hit on McLeod, knocked him down, and then the puck lifted down the ice by the Predators. That'll result in an icing call, and McLeod did not like that hit right in front of the net, and he went right over to that player that got him. I believe it was Roman Josi, who nailed McLeod in front, and then Gostad and O'Brien have to be separated as well. Yeah, that is Josi number 59. Boy, he just really clocked McLeod while they were standing in front of the Nashville net.
Have another look at the hit, and both of these clubs play a very physical brand of hockey.
That's actually Gabriel Bourque, number 57.
That's a good, hard hockey play right there. But McLeod says, I don't care if it's a good, honest hockey play. You don't do that to me.
But then McLeod, I think that he went over to Josi.
57, 59. It close Somebody, enough.
Somebody's going to pay the price.
Say it. If you're in the 50s, Cody's coming after you.
Hunwick moves the puck off the boards. Zip back in. Shut down the ice by Elliott of the Avalanche. Rene sends it around the boards. Kostitsyn, 2-on-1, Preds pass, and the one-timer fanned on by Erat behind the net. Sergei Kostitsyn centering pass. Bounce back towards the blue line. Behind the net, Erat, chased by Elliott. Pass broken up by Landeskog in a nice steal. And then one hands the puck down the ice. Rene, we've seen him through the years, loves to handle the puck, unafraid to move it around.
He attacks that puck every time it's shot into the zone. His idea is go get it and get it out myself.
Fisher sends the pass across. Weber's chance, stick save by Varlamov. Back to the point, Suter slides it across for Weber. He winds, he shoots, blocked by Stastny. Smashed back behind the net for Erat into the corner. Kostitsyn again with a puck. And Nashville holding the puck in the Colorado zone for a little bit. Finally, the Avs are able to move the puck down the ice, but Jay Weber after it. Checked by Stastny. Flicked back behind the net and begins. This line has been the most effective line for the Avalanche in this game. Jones, McGinn, and Stastny. McGinn has the goal for Colorado to the point for Hudek, stolen. Pass to center ice. And Hornqvist. 20 goals this season going after the puck. Rolled it back behind the net. McGinn waves it back into the near side corner. Backhanded up the board. Swatted it by Jones, but taken away in the slot. Pass by it towards Hornqvist. Bouncing puck comes into the near side corner. Red still with the puck at the point. Leg one. Hit by Jones. The puck tapped ahead. Wilson got it across. And McGinn, who had lost his stick back in the Colorado zone, kicked the puck in.
It was actually Stastny lost his stick, and McGinn gave Stastny the stick so he'd be stronger defensively.
Hornqvist coming wide. Moving behind the net. Hornqvist mishandles the puck as he stick handled up the boards. That allows Hajduk come out to center. He's shoved away. And the pass comes to the near boards for Andre Kostitsyn.
This is just a miserable game to be an offensive player. Shots right now, 11-7. The Avalanche have actually had a couple of shots in this period, but there are just not many scoring opportunities.
Nashville continues to lead 2-1, 13:45 to go in the period. Centering pass for 2-2. Lobbed it into the near circle. Suter shoots the puck wide. Weber waiting at the far side point. His shot didn't get through. There's a chance, the save by Varlamov. Back to the near side wall. Pass to the point by Spaulding. Shot by Suter. Pinball to the far side. Big drive by Weber. And the puck is covered. Long enough for a whistle. Again, that big shot by Weber, and then Nashville crashing the net. But Varlamov comes up big for the Avalanche. He's been making some saves here in the second period, keeping this a one-goal game.
Well, here is that bubble that we've been talking about. You see Chicago, Phoenix, San Jose in right now. And you see where the Avalanche are, and the situation is, Mike, they have played just more games than the clubs that are ahead of them. So they have to keep going. The yellow star to the left, those are teams playing in tonight's game. And Columbus, who beat the Avalanche, of course, 2-0 in Colorado, is playing pretty well. And they are right now ahead of the Los Angeles Kings, who won here last game. Mike, 3-1, Jack Johnson, who was a big part of that trade, picked up the second goal of that game.
We'll have highlights coming up during our second intermission. Get you updated on those games as we continue to do a lot of scoreboard watching this time of year. Nashville with the puck from the point. It's Weber. Wrister caught by Varlamov. Luxury has an address. Cooney Lexus invites you to see the full line of Lexus all-wheel drive sedans and luxury utility vehicles for 2012. Available at Cooney Lexus of Littleton on South Broadway and at the top of Motor City in Colorado Springs.
You see a lot of conversation, Mike. The Avalanche don't have time for practice. So these new players are learning in the games, situations, what to, you know, where you can depend on your teammates. The Avs, just with 10 games and 17 nights, don't have a chance to sort of break things down in practice.
I went to the practice yesterday, and with all these games, the practice can't last too long, even on those days when you do have an opportunity to get on the ice. It's just over a little more than a half hour of work. Pass up ice, over the line, leg one, behind him, Andre Kostitsyn. With the puck, coming down the slot, moves it across. Shot by Josi, missed. Around the boards on a hop and out the center. That man pass slips by everybody. Retrieved out of the corner by Wilson. And the Avs playing with five defensemen. An injury in the last second of the first period to Eric Johnson. We don't know exactly what the injury is. We have not had a report yet. Side of the net, but he has not played here during the second period. Center ice, yep. Drop pass, Gostad up the wing. Back to Gostad, tipped it. But Elliott swung it wide, played back to the point. Ellis, his shot misses the net. will go off the backboard, put out in front, dragged right there in the crease, shot, and where's the puck? Oh, it comes wide into the corner. The referee was looking in the back of the net, but the puck went to the side. Gostad, centering try for Yip. Taken away by O'Brien. Around the boards to center ice. McClement shoots the puck in.
It's starting to tilt a little bit towards Nashville as far as the pressure that they've having on the other team's goaltender.
14-7 shot advantage, Nashville. But just a one-goal game. Backhand try. The save by Rene. It's Mark Olver making trouble going down the slot.
Now for the Avalanche. Look at that last little rush. Peter Mueller, of course, himself returning from that torso injury. He's had, Mike, the last couple of games assists on the game-winning goal. But here's that play, just a scramble in behind. And Nashville, you see how they pressure in front. And again, we talk about the idea that frees up those defensemen to come in and help out offensively. They're just sitting out there like sharks waiting for that puck to pop out.
Based on the Nashville zone, 10:53, remaining second period. 2-1 lead for the Preds. Quick outlet pass. 2-2 moves it ahead. Picked up. Havlicek. Just the puck behind the net for Nick Smalling. He's held by Hunwick. Pass to the wing for Connolly. Chasing the corner. Back up the boards, Hunwick's chance, kick, save, rebound, shot, waved away. Boy, you saw that full leg extension on the kick by Rene. That one was headed to the back of the net. Great save. Centering pass, shot, another big save by Marlowe. Shot, save, rebound off the side of the net. Centering pass, backhand, knocked down by Marlowe, picked up and played off the glass, but not out by Connolly. Connolly picks up the puck. Pushes it up ice for Mueller. He winds. He shoots. And it's kicked wide by Rene. Up the boards. Back to the point. Hayden with a drill. Safe. Rebound. Oh, it was right there. Knocked away. Nashville with some support for the goalie. Saving a goal.
Now we got a hockey game.
Yeah.
Now we're seeing the two guys, Pekka Rene and Varlamov, showing what they, how they've been playing.
Up the boards through the pass. Avalanche managed to keep it in momentarily. Then Sergei Kostitsyn's pass over the line for Fisher. Dropped it. Erat misses the far side. Yossi's pass for Fisher. Broken up. And iced by the Avalanche. 9:07 remaining. Pace picking up here in the second period.
Well, let's look at a couple of replays of the action. Mike Connolly, his second game in the NHL, comes just that close. Makes a nice play, but good support in and around. Defenseman helping out players down low. And Ryan Suter, Mike, boy, oh boy, is he going to be an interesting situation if Nashville can't get a contract signed. And he tests that free agent.
Unrestricted,
free.
Behind the net, Andre Kostitsyn makes the pass for Hornqvist. Off the boards to the point, Gill slides it across. One-timer save made by Varlamov. Downey for the Avalanche to the red line. Shoots the puck in. Rene handled the puck. Just tap back behind the net for Gill. That long reach, able to get around behind the net. Sends it across over the line. Coming down the middle. Bouncing puck, Kostitsyn sent it across, and Leguan was there, and he has the puck. Leguan with it, centering pass, comes all the way back to the point. Bouillon winds and shoots, save made by Varlamov. Rebound comes back towards the point. Bouillon sends it to the half boards, taken away by Stastny to McGinn. Bounced the puck into the national zone, 8 minutes left. Stastny fends off a check, centers in front. Back towards the point, but it slips out to center.
And this line continues to apply pressure.
Threw off the boards, and on a hop comes into the Colorado zone. Rammed up the far side boards. Jones carries the puck in. His shot gloved by the goaltender Pekka Rinne. in Music City. The hometown team leading 2-1.
We have watched, I think Mike will look back and we'll say we watched Semyon Varlamov grow during this season, 2011-2012. His ability to learn from little things from Shakir, but more importantly, how to be that number one goaltender, how to be that guy night in, night out, that comes up with the saves right now, that keeping his team in the game. One more goal from Nashville, the Avalanche are down to 5, defensive could be tough, and he's keeping him right there, one play away from tying this game up.
7:37 remaining. Gostad tossed out of the faceoff circle. In his yip against Olver. Avs do win the draw. Conley to Mueller. Back to the points, but out to center ice. O'Brien. Just the pass to Hunwick. Angles it off the boards in the neutral zone. Shot back by Nashville to the Avalanche end. Hunwick will pick it up. Drop it behind the net for O'Brien. His pass deflected by Yip and blocked. Karam's back behind the net. Lifted up and out by Hunwick and Olver in a race. And Olver, a burst of speed right at the end, got to the puck. Nashville retrieves and shoots the puck to center. Olver with that hustle took away that icing. Downey for Colorado. Shoots the puck to center ice. Nashville's got to get back on side. As Kostitsyn moves the puck off the boards for Fischer. Back towards Sergei Kostitsyn. Charging in. He is hooked by O'Brien. That will be a penalty. And Shane O'Brien with his second minor penalty of the game is headed to the penalty box. And Nashville will get their second power play of the game.
Have a little look at this. I'm also watching. I'll tell you, this Landeskog, he doesn't fool around. He thought there was a little bit, yeah. He just threw that, the stick came, he fires it in the air, and then he went over and talked to Kostitsyn and said, you know what, stand up. That, you know, you didn't have to go down like that right there. But I'll tell you.
The rookie in the league, you know, 19, he's not afraid to.
He's not afraid of anybody.
After the draw, shot up off the boards out in center. Peter, in the old days, it was supposed to be like children, right? You're supposed to be seen, not heard.
Oh, yeah.
Things are different. Blocked, puck down low, and that's tipped. Oh, Fischer had a point-blank chance. I have to look at the replay. I think, did Varlamov poke, put the stick out there and deflect it, or was it the defenseman? Let's see.
No, it's one of those plays, again, even if Varley doesn't get to it, it's his awareness on the ice. Yeah, he got it. I think Varlamov's got a little piece of it. This will be a better angle. Comes across. No, the stick of the defenseman. Yep, the stick of the defenseman, Hunwick, who has himself played so well since stepping in.
Brian in the penalty box. Poking penalty at 13:26. And Nashville, second best power play in the league. 1-for-9 in 2 previous games against the Avs. 0-for-1 tonight. Back up to the point for Suter. Has Weber on the far side. Goes that way with the pass. Back to Suter. Down the near side boards for Kostitsyn. He's surrounded and lost the puck, but Suter, so smooth and patient, waiting for it, kept it in. Pass in front. Kostitsyn trying to tip that pass from Weber. Andre Kostitsyn makes the pass to his brother Sergei into the corner, up the boards, and shot down the ice. I don't know whether Rene didn't realize it was his teammate behind for a moment. There was a little panic, wasn't there?
And it was like, give it to me. You know, no, Rene wanted it, you know. He wanted to make that outlet pass.
Fisher's shot ends up going into the netting. Out of play. It's all about family. You can treat your loved ones to the Avalanche experience on Saturday when the Avalanche host the Oilers. It's a 1 o'clock game. 4 tickets, 4 Pepsi, 4 family meals for just $99.
And Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, who's had a few injuries, but boy, oh boy, What a player he is going to be for the Edmonton Oilers, taken first overall in this last draft. Landeskog, number two in the same draft.
We'll flip pass to the corner. Back up the boards to the point. Split across for Josi to the other point. Ellis gets the pass. He winds. He shoots. Hit a body in front. Fisher waiting. The near side point. Trying to saucer a pass, but O'Reilly, he's about as good as anybody in this league doing that. Blocked that chance. The Avs, among the best teams in the league in those takeaways. Erat carrying back the other way. Good as the Nashville power play is, they haven't been able to do the job and score goals against the Avalanche in their two situations. Here's an odd man rush happening for the Avs. Three on one. Wilson's pass zipped away from O'Reilly. Looked to the center ice for Fisher. Carries the puck in. 4 minutes left in the period.
That was the defenseman Wilson. He was trying to move it over to the center iceman O'Reilly in that play.
And in front of the net. Drop pass taken away. Jones sprints out to center. Bounces off of a hit of Malachuk. And then Bouillon puts the big hit on Jones. Back in around the boards. Stastny kept the puck in to the corner. Again. Stastny. Pass. O'Brien. Saved by Rene. Former Nashville Predators Shane O'Brien walking right in and got a great pass. But Rene with a big save. 2-1 Nashville.
During the TV timeout, the good news for the Avalanche, Eric Johnson comes back, tries it. You know, the coaching staff is watching him right now. And he's going to get, you know, he's testing that leg. He goes over and says, it feels okay, Mike, and he is back out there for the Avalanche. And you talk about winning your teammates over. This is the kind of play that does that.
There he is, Eric Johnson. 3:25 left in the period.
But if you're Nashville, Mike, what do? You throw it in his corner and see if he can turn. See if he can turn and get back. I mean, hockey players aren't necessarily the nicest guys when 2 points are on the line.
Suter comes away with the puck. Pass up ice. Carried over the line. Coming in 2-2. Shot tips. And the puck goes out of play.
And you don't get that opportunity to really skate around too much because Johnson got hurt right at the end of the first period. Mike, there's 17 minutes intermission and then 17 minutes of ice time played. You're talking about probably 45, 50 minutes ago since he skated. So that was a good short shift, get himself to feel, you know, maybe a little bit more comfortable.
Hayden slammed the puck around the boards. It's by Weber at the point. And he makes the handoff. The shooter. He gets blocked. Weber will take it. He's in the cross. Landeskog putting that full court pressure on. Near side, Suter. Up ice. Cross ice pass for Erat. Hand up to Fisher. Centers in the slot. Kicked. And then the save by Varlamov. O'Reilly dribbles the puck across. Hayden. Pass to center ice for Landeskog. He shoots the puck wide. Waiting on the near side, O'Reilly, but the puck skims past him. Up ice for Steetson. Over the line for Weber. There's Rester going wide, but gloved by the Avalanche goaltender Varlamov. The Colorado Rapids kick off their season at home Saturday at 4 o'clock. They'll be hosting the Columbus Crew. Get your tickets at TicketHorse.com or go to ColoradoRapids.com and find out all the information about the Rapids. They begin their season this Saturday.
The Avalanche have an opportunity. They get Stastny out for faceoffs. 18-3 last game against Minnesota.
Bounced around the boards, tipped out to center ice. Jones scoops up the puck. His shot deflects and goes out of play.
Well, David Jones, I think it was interesting listening to him talk about the chemistry, the line, and really, I think, described it well. You got Jones, fast, And I mean, big on that right side. You got McGinn, fast and big on the left side. You get in, you pound it in, you move the puck to Stastny, who was so good at moving and finding that open guy.
Ball start. A redo on the faceoff. Now, one of the keys tonight, the Avalanche staying in this one with a couple of nice penalty kills. Nashville in their two power play chances had only two shots total. Back to the point for O'Brien. Shot. Around behind the net. Tipped to the corner. Lifted up by Andre Kostitsyn to center ice. And in around the boards. Rene waiting behind the net. The puck bounced over his stick. Out of the pass to center. For Kostitsyn. Coming down the middle. Hand off Gostad. Shots and sliding across. The puck is stopped by the goaltender Varlamov.
Well, it's been a very interesting season for defensemen around the league. And but you look at the scoring race, and it's not a race. It's just a lap in the field by Carlson of Ottawa. I mean, a lot of people are talking about Suter and Weber for the Norris Trophy that goes to the best defenseman. And Campbell, of course, your forward, has done a nice job. I don't see how you can't vote for Carlson. He's averaging 25 minutes. He's a plus 14. And Ottawa is the surprise club of the whole Eastern Conference. I mean, the young kid has just been unbelievable. He's got a 23-point lead in defenseman scoring.
And center ice, the puck then lands out of play.
And there they are. There's Ryan Suter on the right and Hal Gill on the left. But again, Suter is, you know, Mike, you watched him here tonight. He is effortless in the moves that he makes. And he doesn't seem to get touched, because he always is just that one step ahead of you mentally. You come flying in, he just sort of chips it by and bounces
Peter,
by.
We're going to have a fight. It is going to McLeod and Jordan 2-2, and a right by McLeod, another right by McLeod, and 2-2 comes in a little bit closer. Boy, McLeod landed some good punches. 2-2 trying to come back with that left hand, and another uppercut, and another one by McLeod, and they continue to dance, and finally McLeod lands on top of Jordan 2-2. Boy, some quick punches thrown by McLeod on Jordan 2-2.
You know what? I guarantee you, McLeod has studied 2-2's fights. Because what does McLeod usually do? He usually tries to get the left arm out and throw the right bomb. There, he knows 2-2 throws quick ones. Get him in close. Watch this. Watch him. And McLeod just says, you know what? You want to start that? I'm going to throw as many as I can, too, and keep that right hand under. 2-2 never got that his hand up and over, and McLeod just kept throwing him and throwing him and throwing him. Because 2-2 is one of those guys, if he gets control, I mean, he starts pulling you down, starts firing him up, you're in trouble. And McLeod really handled it well and really handled him in that fight.
Five-minute majors given to 2-2 and McLeod. Continue now with a minute 20 left in the second period. There's Cody McLeod. His 15th fight of the season.
And Mike, in this second period, I've been watching Weber. He is looking for a hit. He is coming up in the play. He is coming up hard. Somebody's going to pay the price pretty soon.
Well, last minute of play. Behind the net, Weber. Moves the puck around the boards. Reverse back behind. Off the boards to center ice for Bork. Lob the puck into the Colorado zone. Landeskog from the backboard. Flag down, shot scored. Sergei Kostitsyn with his 17th goal of the season. That just took a bad bounce for the Avalanche on that clearing attempt. And it landed right on the stick of Kostitsyn, and he didn't miss.
At the Avalanche. Landeskog, I mean, Mike, there's a play there that he probably wishes he had back. You don't go back across the front of the net. I mean, it's just a play that there's well-coached, good clubs will have players in those passing lanes. One of the ones you need to fire up the wall, but you know, it just still, it's a learning process no matter who the player.
And a late goal by Nashville. Now we got a little something else. And Downey is involved. You see him, number 27 for the Avs. His helmet's come off. He's trying to get, I think it's Fisher he's trying to get at. Yeah, he's got a hold of Fisher. Helmet of Downey is off. Fisher's helmet's coming off. The linesman doing their best to pull the two apart. This coming with just 17 seconds left to go in the period. And Nashville now leading the game 3-1.
This is just one of those things for Downey. You see him get knocked over. He says, you know what? You want to do that? Bang. You betcha I'm going to come at them. Then guys come at him. I mean, this is the first time we've seen Downey go after him. But the guy that knocked him down backs right up away from Downey and lets Fisher come over and handle things. And I guarantee you, Downey, I've seen him go. Whew, he ain't the biggest guy, but he can go. And I'm sure Barry Trotz wants an extra penalty on that play.
Well, we'll wait and see how the penalties are going to be dished out. And there is the referee, Stephen Walkham.
You know what he just handed? I think he just handed a tooth to the trainer. Something was handed to the trainer. Now,
here's your Colorado Chevy scoring summary. Sergei Kostitsyn, 17th of the year in 1928. Malachuk with the assist, 3-1 in favor of Nashville. And we are done with the second period of play. Back to Renee, turning away all the shots that he faced during the second period. He saw 9 of them. And then the goal late in the period by Sergei Kostitsyn has made it 3-1 favor Nashville. Avs got some work to do in the third.
Yeah, they sure do against a very good goaltender, very good defensive club, a very good team. So it's going to be early and they need some offensive pressure.
40 minutes to play in Smashville. It's 3-1 in favor of the Predators. Stay tuned for the Subaru Intermission Report. Colorado Avalanche Hockey on Altitude is brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. GEICO, 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Visit us at geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. 5-Hour Energy. Hours of energy now, no crash later. For information, visit 5hourenergy.com. Chase. Take a step forward with Chase Quick Pay by sending money as easily as sending an email. And by Chevy. Visit your Colorado Chevy dealer today. Nashville got a late second period goal from Sergei Kostitsyn to make it a 3-1 game as we go to the third period of play. And as we look, Peter, at the Western Conference standing, we know already that L.A. has lost tonight.
L.A. loses tonight, so the Avalanche stayed right with them as far as points. And you just look at Nashville right now, 83. And again, what they're hoping to do, Mike Nashville, talking to some Nashville people before, in between periods, they'd love to catch Detroit or St. Louis, whoever falls into that four spot, get into four spot themselves, so they have home ice. Home ice in the Central Division is ridiculous. It is absolutely ridiculous and may be paramount in getting out of a series like that.
How about that? You can end up, if it's a good season like Nashville has, and then you're going to end up playing in the first round, either Detroit or St. Louis. Oh, boy.
Two very different hockey clubs. Ken Hitchcock right now, what a job he's done. They were in first place in the Western Conference and tied with New York as far as points coming into tonight's action.
Very impressive. Meanwhile, the Avalanche concerned here in this third period, trailing by 2 goals. Avs have just 12 shots in this game, but Nashville hasn't exactly been lighting it up either. They only have 22 shots in the game.
Mike, I was watching to see, because sometimes things can tighten up. Eric Johnson back on the ice, again to start this third period for the Avalanche.
He's out there right now, paired up with Shane O'Brien. Nashville with the puck. Nice move. The shot. And comes through the crease underneath Varlamov. O'Brien without a stick has to play the puck. Behind him for Landeskog. Skates out to center to the red line. Gets into the zone for the trailer. O'Brien walks in, and it hit a skate of Roman Josi. O'Reilly with the puck for the Avalanche, chasing to the corner. Going to go back to the point, but O'Brien had snuck in a little bit, so the puck came past him. Johnson fending off Erat. Lost the puck. Erat with it. Dropped it. Shot high. And around the boards. Scooped up by Legwan, who just missed that shot. Erat comes out in front. Off the skates, but covered in the crease by the goaltender. Semyon Varlamov for the save. Then Legwan, and that is O'Brien. His former teammates going at it around the Avalanche net.
Well, if you're Semyon Varlamov, you know right now that you probably can't allow another one. If the Avalanche are going to get this game maybe into overtime. There's that, just that shot wide, high and wide. Farley diving across. Be interesting to see. Now, next game is an afternoon game against Edmonton, who Coach Sackle goes in nets in that game, because as we mentioned, so many games coming so quickly at the Avalanche.
After the faceoff, Elliott rolls the puck up the boards, and the tip sends the puck to center ice. Brought in offside by the Avs.
All right, well, you know what? Time for our Toyota Saving the Game.
Look at this. Plays of goaltender Pekka Rinne.
So many people we talked to.
That was a big one there, on O'Brien.
Yeah, O'Brien. That was a huge save. And you look at it, because that wasn't that much, Mike, earlier than, or, you know, wasn't that much before the goal by Nashville to make it 3-1.
Elliott coming back for the puck. Tied up behind the net by Gabriel Bork. Gostad works the puck free. Moving along the boards to the corner. Reversing. Gostad. Going to use his size to stay away from Stephen Elliott. Pass to the point for Ryan Ellis. Behind the net for Bork. Slides free. Makes the handoff to the defenseman. Ellis trying to chip the puck out in front. Land on the side of the net. Turned back behind. And the pass for Hunwick. And that pass can go all the way down the ice into the Nashville zone. Right in front of the net. Taken by Francois Bouillon. His pass comes to the other defenseman, Ellis. Up ice. Steetson shot saved by Varlamov. Right over the line. Steetson takes it back. Well, those brothers, it's an interesting story. They were playing both for the Montreal Canadiens. And there was some off-ice stuff that happened, and boy, if anything happens in that town, it's front page news. And Sergei Kostitsyn ended up with Nashville, and then the trade for his brother, and they've got some talent, that's for sure, as Rene makes the save.
Yeah, the Kostitsyn, what they add, no question, is that element of skill on its Nashville club. Nashville now has 10 guys that have scored at least 10 goals this season. And that is right at the top of the league. And as you mentioned, the Kostitsyn brothers.
That's Mike, Andre there.
That's Andre right there, who just this year came over from Montreal. Montreal, boy, it's been a miserable year. That's got to be a long year, being in last place in the East for the Montreal Canadiens. It's tough enough.
After the faceoff, the puck to the point. O'Brien for Downey. Check. Last period, right near the end of the period, both Steve Downey and Mike Fisher got 2-minute minors for roughing. Shot by Erat, gets tipped, and the puck goes out of play.
Oh, Martin Erat, He has basically been here since the beginning for Nashville. One of those guys that just year in, year out. You talk about consistency, Mike. Look at those points, 48 points. It's been eight consecutive years where he has had between 48 and 57 points. Talk about knowing what you're going to get from a guy.
It's 10 points in six games against the Avs. Scoot back behind the net. Chased down by Spaulding from Nashville. Upended. Stefanelli works the puck free. Cut off by 2-2 centers. Turned back to the point. Suter shot. Saved by Varlamov. Shot. Another save. And Varlamov spinning as he makes that save. And the puck travels down the ice back into the Nashville zone. It's going to end up being an icing.
Yeah, when you're watching Varlamov, like looking up and over, the active situation, but he is great movement, but there's not that over movement. Look at him, he's on there, he's making that save. Guys are all over him, knocking him down. He ran over into his own guy in that play.
Jones lifts the puck through center. Cutting across, Josi. Couldn't get it out of the zone. Stassi's got it for the Avalanche. Centering pass. Moves it behind the net. Mueller shot. Score! Paul Stastny from Peter Mueller, and the Avalanche are within one. Stastny scoring the goal. His 17th of the year. His second point of the game. And the Avalanche now trail by one with 15 minutes to go.
And Stastny, who now in this game, a goal and assist. What comes out? Stastny just does a nice shot. That's a tough puck to find. It's a tough puck to shoot. But Mueller goes behind. He sees Stastny. Nice cycle. Because I'll tell you, Nashville.
All three of those guys turned,
yep,
didn't they? Behind the net.
All three of them watched the puck. No one picked up Stastny. And Stastny was that one guy that should have been grabbed the minute he came in front of the net, but didn't take advantage of a not very often miscue by the Nashville Predators.
So the Avalanche now trail by one. And some of those saves by Varlamov kept the Avalanche close. Now they've got an opportunity here with under 15 minutes to go. Over getting involved, he got a push from the goaltender Rene and then other Nashville Predator teammates went after Mark Over.
You gotta wonder, did he say something? Did he give him a little whack? Because it was Pekka Rinne that gave him a little shot. But you know what? Just listening to him talk in the morning and when you're talking, he loves this. He loves the competitive nature of all of this. He didn't really do anything in that play, but he...
Well, it doesn't look like we're going to have any penalties, so we'll resume play here in the third period. The Avs have just scored a goal. Paul Stastny. In the 17th of the season, the Avalanche now trail 3-2. Let's give you the full Southwest scoring summary. Goal coming at 4:58. And one assist, and it goes to Peter Mueller. Mueller now with six assists this season. 5 goals, 6 assists for Mueller. Varlamov sends the puck to Wilson. Off the boards, up ice. Cross ice, Downey to Landeskog. O'Reilly going down the middle. Pass, though, tipped away. Carried up ice by Kostitsyn. He's got Fisher with him. Kostitsyn shot. And stopped by Varlamov.
Well, it has been an interesting night with one of those little sidebars. The O'Reilly line against Weber and Suter. It has been a long night.
Avalanche got a goal from Paul Stastny. Now they're within one in the third. Coors Light bringing you What's on Tap. Saturday, it's a matinee game between the Avs and Oilers. And so important for the Avalanche. They take on Edmonton. We'll have our coverage starting at 12:30. Here on Altitude.
There's one thing.
Love those afternoon games.
Yeah, they're great. They're fun. There's always a lot of families there. and Edmonton Oilers can skate. So you know it is going to be a high-energy hockey game.
To center ice, David Legwan on a hop, sends the puck in. Smashed around the boards by Varlamov. Jones got it back for Colorado. Hunwick's pass up ice. And then shot into the national bench by a teammate. That was towards the head, almost close to the head coach, Barry Trotz. Apparently that Nashville player didn't just want more minutes. Wasn't happy with his minutes tonight.
Yeah, didn't get enough ice time there the first couple periods. But you know, it has not been a great year for coaches. Todd McClellan, coach of the San Jose Sharks, got hit in the head, Mike. Great article that he wrote, his new appreciation for concussions. But the first concussion, Mike, that he's had where he said if he had had to play, he couldn't. And he maybe a better understanding of what this whole thing is about as far as the head injuries. And you hate to see it for a coach, but you know, if it's one of those things where maybe you get a little better understanding.
And then we'll see Edmonton on Saturday. Didn't Tom Rennie get hurt?
Rennie got hit in practice. And it was Todd McClellan called Tom Rennie and said, hey, what am I looking at here?
At center ice, McClement coming into the Nashville zone. Hip check to the ice by Ellis. Boyan going with the puck. Johnson coming down from that point. Can muscle his way in. Backhander try. Stop. Shot up high by Hayden. Around the boards. The puck pops up in the air. Up by Wilson behind the net. McClement. He's got McLeod in front. Pass. Stop. Clement gets it again. It's a good shift for the Avalanche. And the pass gets across. Hayden works the puck down the boards. Bouillon put it back up to the near side. And it is cleared out by Nashville. But that was a good shift for Colorado.
And that line, McClement, Hayduk, and McLeod back together here a little bit in this third period. McLeod coming off a two-point game goal and assist.
Hayduk moves the puck off the boards to center ice. By over. And offside Avalanche. 12:09 to play in the third.
Now Peter Mueller, as we talked about the last couple of games for the Avs against Minnesota, he had a power play, a couple of assists, including a power play assist in the first game, a big power play assist. It was an assist in the game winner the last game against Minnesota, Mike. So now an assist here and a big goal by Paul Stastny.
Over. Not allowed to take the face off. Mueller will take it for the Avalanche against Matt Halichuk. Gillen over, going to the corner for the puck. Mark Freen, Yossi after the puck. He scored one of the three goals in this game for Nashville. 2-2 and Hayda. As the Avs will come up with a puck over. Twisting back in. Turns the puck across for Connolly. Tutu took a run and over. Hayda moves the puck into the corner. And then Tutu takes a run towards the corner. And Connell. Tutu's on the ice and you're on the other team. You better keep your head up.
Oh, he's coming. Yeah, he's Nashville's Cal Clutterbuck. He is coming all the time.
Air down the wing by Stastny, trying to drop it for Jones. It's been the line for the Avalanche in this game offensively. McGinn. Hit against the boards. Comes up with the puck. And Erat slapped at it. Didn't get out of the zone. The Avs continue to put some pressure on. Justichen's pass to center ice for Erat. And it's shot in. Scooped around the boards. Hunwick. Pass to Stastny. To Johnson being chased by Hornquist. Johnson darts back behind the Avalanche net. Behind the net, Suter. Touch it, ice it.
Mike, they set out the schedule remaining games of all the clubs on a nice sheet of paper. One of the things I noticed was strength of schedule remaining. Look at the Avalanche. Number one, the hardest schedule of any of the 15 clubs in the Western Conference. The teams they play have been playing almost 600 hockey. Nashville, one of those clubs, two games against Vancouver. That East Coast trip, Buffalo, who lost, unfortunately, tonight for them. Mike, they've been hot of late, but then New Jersey. And then your New York Rangers.
That's coming up next week. Avalanche go Wednesday, Buffalo, Thursday, New Jersey, and then Saturday, the day after St. Patrick's Day. Or actually, on St. Patrick's Day. On March 17th, Saturday night, the Madison Square Garden against the Rangers. Hunwick coming in, but proceeded over the line. Offside Avalanche.
Many people call that the most dangerous day in New York. St. Patty's Day.
Other people say it's the best.
A bunch of Irishmen running around the town.
What could go wrong
what
there?
What could go wrong? Possibly
on a Saturday night?
On Saturday night. Bunch of Irishmen downtown New York. Just nothing.
I don't see any potential for disaster. Off the draw. The puck comes through the circle. Wilson pushes across. Downey. Broken up. Gets it back. Sent across for Hayda. He winds and snaps that puck around the shelf. It drops over to Downey. Again, the Avalanche, a little bit of time here in this Nashville zone. They picked up some momentum since the goal from Stastny at 4:58. Mueller assisting on that goal. Avs are down by one, but looking in the Nashville zone a little bit here. At the center comes Hornquist. Pass through the middle. Stepping up Wilson. Here come the Avalanche again into the Predator zone. Shot by Wilson. Tip wide. That ricocheted back to the Colorado zone.
Look at the Avalanche. The number is six times this year. They've come back in the third period to win games.
Right down the boards by O'Brien. He follows up. Puck grabbed out of the corner. Hayden makes a pass in the middle. McLeod off the... Did it go in? Or it just hit the crossbar?
Michael, that was not the noise a crossbar makes.
No. That was a different sound, wasn't it?
It was a ping that it hits the cross. I think that's in.
Let's see. We're going to show you a replay as we go to a break. McLeod with a shot, and tough to see from that angle. We'll check when we come back.
Mike, nope. I mean, I even hear things. I'm a homer. But this bounces off the post clearly. Now, it had Pekka Rinne beat, and it just hit the crossbar, a good angle of it right here, and bounces down in behind. The Avalanche come back close.
He never saw it. No. Glove never came down.
No,
until he felt it bounce off the back of him.
Yeah, he heard that, as we did, and then he reacted as he turned back to find it.
9 minutes left. The Avalanche. Some good push here in this third period. They've gotten a goal from Stastny. And have been in the Nashville zone quite a bit. Pass up ice for Hornquist. He got away. He's in. Big save by Varlamov. What a save. Robbing Hornquist, who is tied for the team lead in goals and had plenty of time to make a play. And Varlamov keeps the Avs in it. That puck floats in high. Swung around the boards back to center ice. And that took an Avalanche bounce. Coming in, McGinn, backhand save by Rinne.
Well, let's have a look at some of the action. Now, Hornquist, Mike, he is a lot like Thomas Holmstrom of the Detroit Red Wings, Mike. A lot of his goals are banging away at rebounds. So on that one, Varley just makes a strong save. Just, moves out, takes it away. Nice play by Holmquist to just sort of take the stick away from the Avalanche player and jump into the opening.
As win the draw. And the shot caroms off the backboards. Swung back up the far wing. 8-10 left in the third. 3-2 lead for Nashville, but the Avalanche are coming on here in the third. McLeod, moments ago, hitting the crossbar. Could have tied the game. 2-2 to center. Coming in, he's got some other players with him. The wrist shot stopped by Varlamov. 2-2 scoops up the puck.
turns his pass. Knocked away by O'Brien. Turns it around to the corner, towards the corner. Johnson cut it off. Bounces through, makes the pass up ice for Connolly. And went off his stick in, goes out of play. Well, Eric Johnson, who left the end of the first period in the locker room with an injury and came back late in the second period, and stayed with it here in the third.
And again, when he went off, Mike, we saw Matt Duchene last game with the high ankle sprain out 3 to 4 weeks. You're thinking, oh my goodness, so Johnson now. And fortunately, and with a lot of hockey, you know, that old hockey courage thing, comes back for the Avalanche.
He was helped off the ice by two teammates, and from what we could tell, wasn't putting it much weight on that left leg.
But then when he came out, that's what he seemed to be testing. He was testing his legs, certainly, to see how he felt.
Coming in, that Forks pass broken up nicely by Wilson. Terrific play by Ryan Wilson. Only broke it up and stayed with it. Vice for Over. Shot to the corner. Over staying with it. To the corner. Cross that. Shrugs off Connolly. And the puck is shot up the boards and out.
That is a great hockey sight, isn't it? Oliver at 5'8", 5'9", going in against Hal Gill and just ducking in behind him to get the puck.
Elliott got some pressure from Erat. Fire the puck ahead. Nashville's got to wait to get onside. Fisher shoots the puck in. Friends do get onside. Varlamov spins the puck to the corner. Knocked back around the boards to the near side corner. Behind the net for Erat. Off the boards. Shot by Weber. And he sends a pill to the front of the net. Elliott for the Avalanche to the corner. Broke back around. Downing waiting. Makes the outlet pass for Landeskog. Shot. Try by O'Reilly. Centering pass comes across to the near circle. Hunwick had pinched in. Pass intercepted. Erat bringing the puck in. Makes the drop for Suter. His shot tips. And that puck went out of play. Getting exciting here in the third period in Nashville. Preds lead. Avalanche got off to a good start early on. Jones centering for Jamie McGinn, who gets his 16th of the year. But then Nashville came back shortly thereafter. Fisher got credit for the goal. And then Roman Josi with a shot tipped by Yip. It was 2-1 Nashville at the end of one. Into the second period, late in the period on a giveaway. Kostitsyn buries the puck. Up by two, Nashville to the third, and Stastny fed beautifully by Mueller. Gets the goal, has put the Avs back in the game. They trail 3-2. You can add an assist on that Stastny goal. Originally Stastny from Mueller. Now give another assist to Jamie McGinn. He just keeps piling up the points as an Avalanche.
Three consecutive multi-point games for Jamie McGinn. He had 3 in 61 games for San Jose.
The puck is up and out. And cleared to center ice. Leguan going to make the handoff. Got the puck back from Hornquist. But O'Brien trying to take advantage of Nashville changing up. But he slowed up just as he got to the blue line. That caused the play to be offside.
You have to be impressed with the Avalanche in this third period. For a couple reasons. One, Nashville's been playing real well here at home. It's a tough building to play in. And the Avalanche got scored on late in that second period to the point where you may say, oh, you know, they're going to come out down. But they didn't. They've come out and been very aggressive in this period.
And I think you add in saves by Varlamov, especially the Hornquist.
Yep.
Keeping the Avs right there. Another icing call, this time against Nashville.
A lot of games for the Avalanche that are, you know, they'll be looking at, like, start after this game here. So they're going to be, as they get on the bus tonight and head back, or bus and then get on the plane and head back to Colorado, those finals will come in.
Erat trying to clear, but he didn't make the pass. Landeskog's chance. Tipped out in front. And the Avs staying with it. They keep the puck alive for a moment at least. Well, they're just all over it. Pass up ice for O'Reilly. Lifted in, Erat back for the puck. Dropped in the corner, but the Avs charge after the puck in the corner. Down he had it, lost it. The Avs keep it in. The bottom of the circle. Bouillard spins. Headman pass. Out in center ice for Erat. Lifted in. Where he got to the red line, cut off by the Avalanche defenseman Stefan Elliott. Makes the pass for Downey, smacked from center by Over. Renee dropped the puck behind the net, round four, Weber. 4 minutes to go. Mueller to Over. He's hit by Weber. I think the next 4 minutes here, we're going to see a lot of Suter and Weber out there for Nashville. Pass comes across. Bouillon's pass into the middle. Tutu was hacked on the arm. He's trying to get off. He's going to get off the ice. Not, yeah, he's getting off. And the puck comes to the side of the Avalanche net. Hayden advances back behind the Avs cage with 3:20 left. Pass. Skirts down the boards. Icing. Avalanche. 3:10 remaining.
It's been funny how this game has gone along. Like now all of a sudden, you don't think coaches don't know what's going on. Who are Suter and Weber out there against now?
Out there against the Stastny line.
Out there against the Stastny's line. Because the Stastny and his line mates, McGinn and Jones, have real...
Although it's Suter and Yossi together right now.
It was Weber there for the first part, and now they split things up, and they're going to put Weber out there probably against the O'Reilly line.
Suter gets trapped in the corner. The Avalanche come away with the puck. Pass, though, tipped by Yossi and Suter. Nice pass up ice for Hornqvist. Hayden defending and would not let Hornqvist make a move around him. Up the boards, Gill trying to hold the puck in and bounced off from Jones, goes out of play. 2:39 remains.
And there's Jamie McGinn. Like those numbers, 4 goals, 2 assists. Those are the last 3 games. First couple of games, you know, he didn't get on the scoreboard. Just sort of, you know, we talked about it. It's for any player around the league. That first time you get traded, it is a shock. But it has not taken him long to figure out that, you know what, this is a good situation.
As win the draw, Hunwick. Shoot the puck into the Nashville zone. Centering pass, and it went off of Downey. He was all alone in front of the net. He comes free. Pass, shot by O'Reilly. No, did he hit the top of the net?
Something up.
Went up high and deflected off of something. 2:15 remaining. Offside Nashville. If they touch the puck, delay offside. Yeah, they've blown the whistle. Offside on the Predators.
Oh, the Avalanche. Good hard work again down low. They have been the better club in this third period. What does this hit?
Yeah,
oh, it did. That's 2 crossbars for the Avalanche. Pekarinen certainly got a piece of that one. He didn't see McLeod at all earlier, and that one just bounced up over his head, which is not easy to do.
Weber drills the puck to the Avalanche zone. Johnson reversing behind the net. Gets it up for Oliver, back to Johnson. Shot in. Renee couldn't slow it down. The puck comes to the corner, behind the net. A race to the corner, and Oliver gets there first. To make the pass, Weber broke it up, but then Hadou turns and shoots the puck wide. Collision in the corner, Mueller. Threw it to the side of the net. Weber's pass got tipped. Mueller. Wraparound try by Over is stopped at the post by the goaltender, Rene.
What a shift by Mark Over. He was in 3 different situations where he just outworked the Nashville player to get to the puck. Just comes around, just tries to tuck it in and around. That's the end of it. And Suter pushes. Over pushes back. Suter pushes again. Over pushes back. Again, he's one of those players that probably a lot of the Nashville guys don't have a real knowledge of who he is. So He's skating by the bench. They're going, who is this guy? Not a big guy, but he, believe me, he ain't backing down. Now the Avalanche, Mike, there we go. Pulled their goalie, minute 27.
Face off in the national zone. They've got the extra skater out. Stastny out there with the O'Reilly line. O'Reilly hit, but gets the puck to the corner. Backhanded around, Elliott pinching in. Put the puck in the corner. Avs have the extra skater out right at the side of the net. Chip back into the corner. Stastny gets hit. Suter turns. And it bounces up the boards. And can the Avs keep it in? They do, but Weber, oh, he tried to go for the empty net, but it hit something. Put back in. We're in the final minute. Avs crashed after the puck. They've got it out in front. There's a chance. And it goes wide to the far boards. Landeskog turns and shoots. Had it blocked. Picked up. Erat gets the pass, got a chance to seal it, and he does. That makes it 4-2 with 43 and a half seconds to go.
Well, after losing last game 5-4 to the Los Angeles Kings, the Nashville Predators have come out here and played a pretty solid hockey game. Full marks to the Avalanche here in this third period, but they still at this point sit with just 16 shots on net. And the Avalanche again, Mike, it looks like are going to go through a hockey game without a power play. This is just a club that has drawn the fewest power plays of any club in the league.
194 all season.
Yep.
Well, you knew Nashville, they don't take a lot of penalties. Well,
they're a smart, disciplined club, and we certainly saw that tonight.
Well, for Nashville, they're going to get to 85 points. They try to close in on Detroit. They have to pull their goaltender again, Varlamov, 15 seconds left to go. Oliver, shot, save made by Vinay. Leguan. Backhands the puck out of the zone. It's going to use up the rest of the time, so Nashville will get their 39th win of the season. Pekka Rinne, that's his 37th win this year. That now sets the franchise record for most wins in a season. And for the Avalanche, hard work. They played well, especially in the third period, but up against a very good Nashville team, especially here at home, Peter.
And up against maybe a game they didn't get all the breaks, certainly in this game. Two crossbars in the third period. You saw Fisher's first goal bounce off the leg of one of their own Avalanche's own defensemen. So, you know, it was a tough loss, certainly for the Avalanche. But, Mike, no rest. It'll be a comeback tomorrow, get themselves ready for an afternoon game against Edmonton.
That's coming up on Saturday. All right, let's look at our Coors Molson. Three stars of the game.
Erik Lestinton had the game-winning goal. Jamie McGinn continues to just sparkle for the Avalanche. That line, terrific here tonight against a very good defensive club in Nashville. And Shea Weber, look at those numbers. Five shots, six hits, assist. I mean, that is a Shea Weber special right there.
There's your three stars, and the Nashville Predators get the win tonight. A 4-2 victory over Colorado. We'll see you again Saturday afternoon. It's a 1 o'clock game when the Avs take on the Oilers. Let's get you to the studio. It's time for the Go Toyota Locker Room Report.